Welcome to Let's Play Forza Motorsport 4, Part 73, and in this segment, I am going to be using this Ferrari Dino. Now, there's only one problem with it, though. I bought it for 55,000 credits, because it was the cheapest car I could get at 55,000 credits. Everything else is hella expensive, yo. But, this is D-Class right now, and I need this thing to be in B-Class, so I'm going to go to the quick upgrade shop. I'm going to upgrade this thing to the top of C-Class. As you see here. Those parts. And then I'm going to do a couple other upgrades to A, get this into B-Class, and B, well, B-Class, I don't know. So let's see. First thing I want to do is I want to you know, I'm gonna go with racing tires. Fuck it. I like having grip. All right, that was fully upgraded. Yes, I'm penny pinching with millions because I'm gonna need those millions much later. Q. You know what? That's the only thing I'm gonna do to it. I'll definitely have a power disadvantage, but fuck it. I'm gonna have grip, and that's all I care about. So let's do this shit, yo. To our next event of the list, it's the Ferrari Classics Showcase. Limited to 60s and older Ferraris. And god, these things were expensive, except for the Dino, so yay! Hey, Russo's also driving a Dino, so I'm not alone. Unfortunately, it's Russo, so he sucks. And we're going to a different track. A couple different tracks, at least. That's cool. Starting with Mugello, so, yeah. I will win this race, goddammit. Mark my fucking words. Yeah, I think I have too much grip on this thing. Fuck it, I don't care. This means I need to drive it better. And, like, you know, be, much smoother with, like, counter-steering and stuff. Basically, don't be shit. Is, I know, an impossibility for me, but yeah. Excuse me, sir. Rossi. Please, move it. Move it or lose it, buddy. You're about to fucking lose it, and I'm talking about all of your goddamn limbs. Like, I'm kind of still underestimating the grip of this car. So I'm just taking these turns at really bad, like, speeds and angles and turn-in points, and it's just a fucking mess. Hello, Mueller. You're going to drive the fuck away from me now. Alright, here's where everyone passes me back. Everybody. Okay, just Weber and Evans. So, just swoosh my way around them again. Maybe. Oh, I should have went on the outside. What am I doing? Okay. Final move on Evans. Now, Mueller. How are we gonna do this? And how much do I dare to block? Alright, well, I got a nice advantage around the turn. Didn't even attempt to block because I didn't realize that he was already there. Oh well. And I don't have to deal with Webbins and Eber again. So I just have to get around Mueller again, and considering how close I am already to him, that shouldn't be too hard. just have retarded amounts of grip, and it's kind of hurting me here. It's like it's helping and simultaneously hurting, because it's like, just fuck, get him away. It's okay, I'll do a dive on him here. Just like that. Oh god, almost fuck it up. I'm fucking it up. Counter steering, okay, smooth. Gotta be very careful with the counter steering, and I'm gonna have to block like a motherfucker here. Mirror driving. No, you don't. Okay, I win. Jesus Christ, that was a stupid race. Because I made stupid decisions on upgrades, but fuck it. Okay, so, that was an interesting one. Rossi ended up fifth. Because he sucks at car choice or something, I don't know. So that's one race down. Three to go. Yeah. Alright. Race two, we're at Catalunya, and we're doing the school circuit. Oh boy, oh well. Hey, here's a place where my retarded amounts of grip will actually help. So long as I can, like, put my car in a spot where it's not already being occupied by everyone. Bad start. Very, very bad start. Oh, fuck. It really doesn't help that these guys are constantly fucking swapping positions, and I'm just kind of like, well, it's either I force a three wide and just make everything go awful, or I wait. And risk having things like what Rossi's currently doing happen. Look at that body roll on Miller's car. Just fucking nosedive on the brakes. Alright, now let's catch Rossi, which should not be too difficult, just considering the grippiness, or like the twistiness of this circuit. Then again, I could just be eating my fucking words like an idiot, moron, stupid. An idiot, moron, stupid, yes. Perfect word choice. Yeah, I'm closing the gap pretty well. Oh, even with my stupid amounts of grip, still can't do the sweeper full throttle all the way. Alright, two to go. I have caught the Rossi. I just need to pass the Rossi. Ooh, that's so tight. Pretty sure I was like very, very, very close to touching the tires on the inside of the entire turn. Hey, I got the lead. Hooray. This is officially a lot easier than Mugello. I still have one lap to go. Can't wait for the AI to drive my car into the sand once I finish this race. It's gonna happen. It's later. Nikes. Calm, easy, alright. Hey, Pet Boys. It's been a long time no see. We're coming back. Maybe. And into the grass. Oh, I avoided the gravel. How about that shit? Also, I win. Right. You just lurk. Hey, lurking's fine, Pep Boys. I mean, you know, it's whatever. I don't mind at all. Alright, that went well. So let's move on to race 3. Aww, so close to affinity level up. Alright, race 3. Ladera test track. I think we're doing the short course, though. So, here we go. And once again, I make a very stupid decision in trying to go through the middle. But it's like, oh hey, the door's open, and I just kind of try to go through it without thinking about the consequences. Until it's far, far too late. Oh, these guys are slowing down a lot for the chicane and the hairpin and the Okay. Well, we made it up to second with a minimal argy bargy, so that's good. Just gotta get around Rossi, which, you know, shouldn't be too hard to do. Just like, hey! And just like that, just pull an empty box on him, around the outside, around the outside. The song I'm listening to right now is from the Sci-Fi Crimes album, Junior. Sci-Fi Crimes, another really good Chevelle album. Like every Chevelle album, really good. Cheap pop, thumbs up. Fuck ever, anyways. So yeah, I think the Mugello is going to be the only difficult one here. Because last race is at Hockenheim short. Well, Hockenheim might be an issue, but I don't think the straight parts are long enough to... Like, they definitely don't have any long straights like Mugello, so it should be fine. Oh god. We're good, everything's fine. Almost spun the car, but we're fine. Recognize it. Boy, you need to listen to Sci-Fi Crimes right now. It's a great album. Just listen to the entire discography, beginning to end. Just do it. I demand it. No. Right front of my car is a little bit bent and distorted. Just a wee bit. No big deal. Alright, 2 to go, and 2 seconds up on Rossi. As before, well obviously you need to listen to it more times, since you don't recognize fucking Roswell's spell. So, great overgrip of the Dino. Me car OP on short tracks. Yes, yes. Did an 8-hour spa endurance in Project Cars, and the game didn't like throw you into the fucking heavens out of pit road. Color me shocked. Anyways, I got a rib on Project Cars at every fucking opportunity because I am an idiot. Still salty. Anyways, I win a very easy race around Ladera. Sweetness. And there we go. You know, despite the PI difference between Johansson and Russo and the rest of the field, I'm actually surprised they're sticking with them, the everyone else. Yeah. Cool. Anyways, one race to go. Let's go to it. Okay, final race, Hockenheim shorts. Let's do this shit, my man, dude, bro. I don't know what the fuck I'm saying. Three laps around here. So, off we go. Of course, get the, not a good start, because, you know, the, speed disadvantage. God, we're doing Class A formula for 8 hours? Goddamn. Bet that was a fucking adventure. Speaking of adventure, what are these guys doing up here? A little bit of a argy-bargy going on. Alright, here's the part where I swoosh in and try to not kill everybody, including myself. Hello, Rossi, how you doing? Wrecked my way in a second. Cool. Oh, empty box around Weber. Not quite. Not quite. If I ever use that car in this LP, I'm definitely putting numbers in the fucking number plate spot. Just you watch. Although, considering how expensive that car is, I probably won't be able to won't end up using it. Sadly. So, end P1 at the end of lap 1. Not bad. I just gotta hold it. Once again, I would love to do endurance racing product cars, but, you know, the, very, what's the word? Instability of the game, plus the lack of mid-race saves, is just like, I probably shouldn't do that, Like, seriously, I really, like, God, Project Cars really needs quits, really needed quick saves. Really, really did. If they do add quick saves to Project Cars 2, I'll be, well, my expectations won't go any higher, but I'll be very happy if they do that. That's like one of the things I definitely need to do. Since, you know, like I said, all these super long endurance races in the game. Well, that was in P-Cars 1, I don't know about P-Cars 2. You know, multiple 8, 9, 10, 24 hour races. Basically more super enduros than Gran Turismo 4, and that's saying something. Turn and another easy race down. Cross the line. Yay. It's another case of first race fucking hard and everything after that easy. But that was just because I had the extreme grip advantage. And Weber ended up finishing second in his 250 Testarossa. Good for him. And hey, Russo beat Johansson for seventh. Cool. Alright. Hey, Matt, 150 Affinity XP, or 100,000 Affinity XP for Ferrari. Excuse me. There we go. Oh, fuck. Yeah, GT4 is still my favorite race game as well, Pep Boys. Anyways, there we go. That is the Ferrari Classic Showcase down. I avoided major expenses yet again by just upgrading a cheaper car. So, hooray. Anyways, with that, we'll move on to our next event in the next segment. Stay tuned for that. You know, you have